Hello and welcome back to another review with me, Kevin, from Kevin Grant on Whisky. This week I've got a Highland in Ardnamurchan. Kind of still newish distillery, founded 2014, so they're nearly 10 years old, but I still think they fall under the category of the new ones on the scene, but they've definitely made a massive impact. It's a distillery I love, I've still to go to, but the whisky style I really, really enjoy. What they've brought out this year, and quite recently, I think it was bottled in April, is the Ardnamurchan Sherry Cask release. It's 50% ABV, non-chill filtered in natural colour. What Ardnamurchan do is they like to have half non-peated and half peated to do with their whisky, so they're keeping it kind of in that realm. This here is a 50-50 split, so there's a 50% split from Hogshead, which have held, some of them have held Pedro Jimenez sherry in it, and other ones have had sherry Oloroso. The peated side of it, the next set of casks have all been sherry butts, and they've all been Oloroso, Spanish Oloroso sherry, is where the peated side has came from, is where I'm led to believe. If I'm any good at editing and doing this, I'm hopefully right at the end, I can put down the wee track. The really cool thing with Ardnamurchan is that on the back, they've got a thing called blockchain technology. This shows you from literally barley to glass, or field to glass, where this whisky has came from. A lot of time they'll get their barley from near their office in Fife, and then it gets shipped up. But I think in the future they're trying to grow their own barley fields local and have their local barley at the site, which I think will be really, really cool. You look at Springbank doing local barleys, and we're going to go down that line of this. So I think the PPM that they like to do is round about 30 to 40, kind of in that middle part. So you're looking slightly like Islay have PT whiskey. It's about the 40 to above if you take out Bunahab and you take out more, but everything else is kind of on that higher scale. This being the mix though, there's a softer notes that I'm going to hopefully get from it, and I'm hopefully going to get those kind of lightly peat notes coming through from it, and then big chewy, jammy sherry notes, because the colour of it, as I said, this is non-chill filler, this is natural colour. 50% ABV, and this is the AD sherry cask release. I think there's about 14,000 bottles made of this, round about that number, and this is bottle I think 428, and that's from clicking on that wee blockchain that I was able to see. So as I say, hopefully then they'll be able to put it up and show you how the distillery works and what's in this glass. I'm excited for it. This is that Ben Marnott Ronnie has given me this, a loan of this bottle, so hopefully by the time you get it back, buddy, there's not going to be too much out of it. I'll try to do my best not to overspend on it, on the palate. But let's get this on the nose. Let's have a wee look at the legs, see what we get on the nose, see what we get in the palate. I've got a wee bit of water here. 50% I think is quite a good number, because I like 46 and above, or round about that, but I'm like, I like my cask strength stuff as well. So looking at it straight away, it's quite oily, I would say. The legs are starting to drip down. Is that because of the sherry? Kind of that gooey, sticky sherry notes. But we'll get it on the nose. Got it in the nice Glencairn today. And let's see how we get on for there. It's like a, straight off the bat, I would say, it's like a, what's the word I'm looking for? It's quite savoury. It's savoury on the nose. There's also like a, what's that? Glaze, the drizzle you put on like salads and things. It's got that slight wee tinge of plummy, you know what I'm talking about. The stuff you put on top of salad to make it look good on top of bruschetta and things like that. It's got that, so it's quite savoury. Peat wise, I'm not getting anything. If this was put in front of me and I was to guess if there was peat in it, I would say no at this point. But yes, savoury. That salad drizzle, whatever. I can't believe I forgot the name of it, but it's got that, but it's quite the plummy note to it. And there's a kind of under note, like kind of maybe rose water, rose petals as well. And I think that's going to be due with the sherry. It's a little bit of PX. It's the majority of it is, as I say, Oloroso. But half of that is peated Oloroso as well. I just don't get that in the nose. I'm enjoying the nose on it. Right. Let's get it on the palate. Let's see how this goes here. Challenge everyone. So that peat's hiding in there. That PPM, we can start getting that kind of dry oakiness. It's quite barbecue glaze. It's probably one of the best ways to describe that on the palate. Just at a barbecue sauce on, this maybe dripped onto the coals slightly along those lines. Good mouthfeel, really good finish. Kind of nutty, maybe coming through. It kind of reminds me Boonahaven with their sherry. I usually get a nutty note. I'm slightly getting that here on the finish. I think that peat, no, that mix of unpeated and peated is magic. I really do like that. Add a couple of drops of water. It's 50%, as I say. It's non-chill filtered natural colour. I don't think there's any aggressive kind of alcohol in the palate. I'll see if that changes anything. Balsamic glaze, there you go. That's what it is, like a kind of plummy balsamic glaze is what I'm getting. You know what you would drizzle on, bruschetta, salads, things like that. That's that kind of note with the savouriness behind it as well. There's a kind of, now with that little bit of water, maybe the nose getting used to it, kind of revisiting, as I'm getting a slight burn coming through from it now. And I think that's that kind of peat just trying to release itself out of the glass. I say on the palate, it's just like a kind of barbecue glaze, barbecue sauce dripping onto the coals of a barbecue. I'm kind of getting that with that little soft nutty note at the end. But that the kind of peatiness comes through. This is one I think, if you don't like peat, and I'm not saying trick someone into liking peat to an extent, on the nose, it's not like your Ardbegs, your Lagavulins, Kalilas and so forth. It's not like drawing you back to be, you know, there's peat in the glass. I think you really have to try and find that. And still, there's wee times I'm getting it, there's times that I'm not. But let's try it on the palate again, see if this wee drop of water's changed anything. I don't think it will do much at 50%, but we'll see. Yep, kind of nutty, slightly drying. That kind of the barbecue sauce on the barbecue that kind of dripping on there doesn't go away. On the nose, the rose petal, kind of rose water still staying as well. And the weird thing is, I tried this maybe a couple of weeks ago in a bar, and I got the very first pour, got she uncorked and everything for me, poured it in the glass, and I tried it, and I just thought it was okay. But now, and I find sometimes with whiskey that the more it can develop in the bottle, the better it can become. And for me now, and I wouldn't say I was going into this with kind of a mindset of this was just, I thought it would be better. I'm really enjoying this now. I think there's more notes that I can definitely smell from it that's kind of came through. And I'm not going to lie, I was excited at the time trying it when I got the dram, and it just kind of didn't deliver. But today I'm really, really enjoying this. I think this is a cracking whiskey from the different nose to palate ratio, from the difference in the non-peated casks, the peated casks, from hogsheads to peated sherry butts. I think it's magic. The traceability, everything's good about it. The bottle, just the tiny etching, which has changed. The other thing I forgot to say is all the whiskey as well, and this bottle's from 2018. So we're looking at this, it's 5 years old. It was April 2018. I think it was 20th of April 2018 when this was matured in, or bottled in 20 April this year. I can't remember, it was one of the two, but it's 5 years. We look at it, it's 5 years old and it doesn't taste young. The casks is definitely hiding the youngness of the spirit. Excuse me, but this is definitely really quality cask that I've been using. I'm just enjoying that wee nutty note at the end as well. This is a really good dram. Ronnie, this might accidentally get lost on its way back to you, so I do apologise for that. Nope, cracking dram by Ardnamurchan. I love the first releases of all the bourbon ones. This is my first real try of the sherry release. I've tried the Madeira, which I thought was absolutely sensational, and the Paulino champagne. So I'm a big Ardnamurchan fan, and I'm glad today that revisiting this when the bottle's kind of gone down further, that it's changed. So sometimes maybe the best wee bit of advice to maybe leave with, if you open a whiskey in the house or you go to a bar and you try that first dram and you're the first person to try it and you get a tight neck pour, which is sometimes things that you'll hear, just give it a wee chance to pour. Pour one for your friend, pour one for someone else, then come back to it when you've got a bit out of the bottle, revisit it and have a real go at it again. So I'm quite happy with this. It's one that I'll definitely think I'll go out and buy now. I've got the Glasgow Whiskey Festival coming up in November, so this could maybe be my purchase of the day, who knows, or maybe put it on a Christmas list. But again, everyone, thanks for tuning in, thanks for subscribing, thanks for liking and following on all the socials. I'm trying to be a bit more active on there, the best that I can. Thanks for everyone that tuned in the other night there when I'd done a live. Obviously got off to an absolute terrible start, but we got there in the end. My wee fruit flies disappeared. Maybe he'll come back one day as well. But I'll try and do some more lives during it, my time when I can. But I'm going to go and sit back. I'm going to go and finish my wee dram, maybe pour another one and just sit and enjoy it. As always, I've been Kevin from Kevin Grant & Whiskey. Join me next week. Let's talk whiskey.